Oh, matter of fact, before we go in and watch this video, do me a solid. Hit the subscribe button below and the notification bell.
Straight to the skin.
That's right.
Read.
And their eyes.
Hey, look, the white woman behind me saying wow because she don't know the Bible. The Bible was never created for her in the first place.
That's right.
Give me Psalms 50 anyway. Read.
And their eyes shall consume away in their holes.
Your eyes gonna be sucked out of your sockets and burnt up.
Keep reading. And their tongue
shall
consume away in their mouth.
That's what the Bible says is gonna happen to this woman right here for interrupting me when I'm reading the Bible. And for you all, no, God blessed us and he cursed you.
That's right.
That's what the Bible says. Read Romans 9. Hold on, you gotta bring that up.
This is the book of Psalms, chapter 50, verse 16. But unto the wicked.
Unto the who?
Unto the wicked.
The so-called white man, the so-called white woman.
God said.
Who are the Edomites according to the Bible. Give me Romans 9 and 13.
What hast thou to do to declare my statutes?
You can't declare anything out of this book. This book was never for you. You stole this book from us when we was in Africa.
That's right.
And guess what? We got it back.
That's right.
And this Bible condemns you and all of your race. Keep going.
Of that thou shouldest take my covenant in thy mouth.
So keep your mouth closed when it comes to this Bible.
That's right.
And don't ever come interrupt me again. Keep reading.
Seeing that thou hatest instruction.
You hate God's instruction.
And castest my words behind thee.
You cast God's words way behind you. Because you the whole reason that this is happening.
That's
on
right.
The Sabbath day.
Right.
So guess what? You got to get that plague.
Right.
You got to get that plague. And everybody with a piece of shrimp in your mouth, you got to get that plague too.
Right.
Read what you got.
Romans chapter 9 verse 13. As it is written.
This is what is written in the Old Testament and in the New Testament. So you so-called Christians that claim you believe in the Bible, you're going to get it from both sides. Keep reading.
Jacob have I loved. But Esau!
But who?
But Esau!
This man right here, the image of the beast, this man right here, God says, how does he feel about him?
Have I hated?
God hates this man right here.
That's right.
This man is Esau right here, and God hates him.
Right.
God condemns him to 1,000 years of slavery.
Right.
And if you want that, we can read that out the Bible too. Officer Kyle, you just let me know. Give me Revelation. Who got it? Give me go to Isaiah 14. You find it in Revelation. I think it's chapter 20. I think it's chapter 20 and like verse 1 through 4, something like that. Somebody find it. Revelation 14, verse 1.
Yes, sir.
Isaiah chapter 14.
This is the book of Rep.
1,000 years, read.
Isaiah chapter 14, verse 1. For the Lord will have mercy on Jacob.
God will have mercy on Jacob. Even for my brothers right here, they're still in the midst of their sin, mercy is still granted to you. You can still grow your beard out and stop cutting it. Matter of fact, I done said that a couple times, but I haven't gotten the law. Give me Leviticus 21.
Sir.
Whoever get it, I think it's Revelation. It's either 20, 19 and 1, 20 and 1, or something like that.
21 and 5?
Yeah. 21 and 5. Okay.
Yes, sir.
All right. So we got it.
This is the book of Leviticus, chapter 21, verse 5.
I done called out a lot of laws. If I haven't read them, we gotta hit the blonde hair. We gotta hit the shaving of the beard. So the Lord says that the so-called black man cannot shave his head, cannot shave his beard.
Right.
We're gonna read it out the scriptures. Read.
They shall not.
Who?
They shall not.
They is the so-called blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans, who are the Israelites according to the Bible.
That's right.
These are the instructions that the Most High God gave to you. Read. Right.
Make baldness.
They shall not make baldness
upon their head.
Read.
Neither shall they shave of the corner of their beard.
This is what the Lord said. And my brother right here packing up the relish and the ketchup says that he's righteous. You're not righteous if you got a shaved head, bro. You ain't got fringes on your clothes. You ain't righteous. You're not keeping God's laws. You got to repent from your unrighteousness and start living righteous. That's what you got to do.
That's right.
Was that it?
Yes, sir.
Give me Leviticus 13.
Leviticus chapter 13 and verse 29. If a man or a woman.
If a man or a woman. So this is for the so-called black woman that always want to dye her head blonde.
Right.
Read.
Have a plague upon the head or the beard.
So the Bible is talking about a plague. The plague. The plague. Read.
Verse 30. Then the priest shall see the plague.
So this is a visible plague that you can see physically on a brother or sister. Read.
And behold, if it be in sight, deeper than the skin.
Read.
And there be in it a yellow.
A what?
A yellow.
A yellow.
Thin hair.
A yellow thin hair. My brother right here. The word blonde is a French word for yellow.
Right.
Black women not supposed to have yellow hair, all right? Don't let your wife do that. Read that again. The last part.
And there be in it a yellow thin hair.
Uh-huh.
Then the priest shall pronounce him unclean.
He's unclean. It's unclean for an Israelite to have yellow hair.
Right.
So we hit the beard, we hit the fringes, we hit the blonde hair. What other laws did we mention?
Pants. Huh? Ball heads.
Pants. Deuteronomy 22 and 5. Our sisters out here wearing pants. Sirach told us that the Lord hates all abomination.
This is the book of Deuteronomy chapter 22 and verse 5.
Down, Sirach.
The woman.
The who?
The woman.
The black woman. With all the attitude. The Bible is talking to you. Read.
Shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
And no, there's no such thing as women's pants. It ain't no dude dresses and it ain't no women's pants.
Right.
That's an abomination according to the Lord.
That read. Right. Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
Go back to Isaiah 14. Go back to Isaiah 14. We're going to bring these scripts out. Ain't nobody right here. That's fine. This is going to give me an opportunity to make sure everything that I say, I'm going to bring it out to scriptures. I'm going to bring it out to scriptures. Read.
Isaiah chapter 14, verse 1.
Matter of fact, before we get there, let's show all of our people why we don't give a damn what the white woman try to come up here and say. Because we're the real followers of Christ. And this is what Christ did when he had a similar woman come up to him. You got give me Matthew 15. Start at what, 22?
Matthew chapter 15 and verse 22. And behold.
21.
Verse 21.
Uh-huh.
Then Jesus.
Who?
Jesus.
Jesus, who we are the real followers of. Jesus had a beard on his face. Jesus had fringes on his clothes.
Right. Right.
Jesus kept the Sabbath day.
Right. Right.
Jesus read and kept the laws of Moses.
That's right.
And that's exactly who we follow. Read.
Then Jesus went thence
and
departed into the coast of Tyre and Sidon.
So we departed where we was from, and we came over here to Buckrow Beach. Read.
And behold,
A
woman.
And what?
A woman.
A woman. It's always a woman that got something to say.
Right.
Keep your mouth closed is what the Bible says.
That's right.
Read. A woman of Canaan came out of the
sea. Whoa. That's not what it says?
That's what she said.
Give me 1 Corinthians 14. Because obviously she don't know the scriptures either.
Bring it out.
All of y'all going to get these verses today.
Bring it out.
Give me 1 Corinthians chapter 14. You got what I want?
Yes, sir.
Bring it out.
This is the book of 1 Corinthians.
You ain't got what I want. 32, 34. Yeah, come on up a little bit closer. Hear what the Lord. Give me that in Timothy.
Yeah, right here to speak.
35, bring it up.
35.
This is the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 14, verse 35.
Uh-huh.
And if they will 34. Learn, that's 34.
Hold on, let that go past, just so that we can make sure that the sister here. This is what the Lord said, read.
This is the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 14, verse 34.
Read.
Let your woman keep silent.
You heard that?
Keep silent.
You heard that?
Keep silent.
Keep quiet. That's what the Bible says. Keep your mouth closed. It's better for you to listen than to get a sacrifice of a fool. And that's what you're doing. Give me that too. Read.
In the church. But it is not permitted.
Read it again.
Let your women.
You're one of our women.
Keep silent.
Be quiet. Be quiet, sister. Be quiet. We don't want to hear what you got to say. You're the author of confusion. Read.
In the churches.
Uh-huh.
But it is not permitted unto them to speak.
It's not permitted for you to say anything. No, you can't speak. You can't speak. Keep reading.
But they are commanded.
You are commanded
to be under obedience.
You're commanded to be obedient,
that's
sister.
Right.
That's what you're commanded to do, to that's be
right.
obedient.
That's right. As also said the law.
The law tells you, you got to be quiet.
Right. Right.
Why? Because the beginning of sin came from the black
that's
woman.
That's right. Right.
Give me Genesis 3 and 16. Give me Genesis chapter 3, verse 16. Y'all ain't never met Christ.
Right.
You ain't never met his real followers, and you ain't never learned the word of God.
That's right.
What you got, read.
Ecclesiastes chapter 5 and verse 1.
We just gonna let them all fly. If y'all not coming here to get edified, you gonna get cut.
Right.
Read.
This is the book of Genesis. Keep thy foot.
Keep your foot in your mouth, black woman. That's what the scriptures say. Read.
When thou goest to the house of God.
This the house of God right here. Don't ever come up to the prophets and think you got something to say or something to teach. It ain't no way you can confound us in these scriptures.
That's right.
Read.
And be more ready to hear.
You see, that's why 1 Corinthians said keep silent.
Right.
Because you need to be more ready to hear. Read.
Than to give the sacrifice of fools.
You're giving a sacrifice of a fool. You speaking on the scriptures, you ain't got your head covered. You ain't keeping the Sabbath. You defiling the Lord's day.
Right.
You ain't got no fringes on your clothes.
Right.
And you want to come say something to us about the Bible?
Nah.
1 Corinthians chapter 14 told you to be silent and in obedience, thus saith the law. Let's show you the law on that. Give me Timothy.
Bring it up. Read.
This is the book of Genesis, chapter 3 and verse 16.
This read it out. This is what law Paul, who you claim to believe in, was quoting that you don't follow. Read.
Unto the woman, he said.
What did he say?
I will greatly multiply thy sorrows.
Your sorrow in what?
And thy conception in sorrow. Thou shalt bring forth children.
So you're bringing forth children in sorrow and in conception. The black women don't have a hard time understanding that. That's why you got tampons. That's why you got periods. That's why you got cramps.
Right.
That's why when you give birth to a baby, you'll tear, right? And then now you got to heal and recover.
Right.
That's why you got to have C-sections, because Genesis 3 and 16.
That's right.
That's the sorrow that you got to go through.
Right.
The black woman don't got a hard time understanding that, because she can feel that. But let's get to the next part.
And thy desire shall be to thy husband.
Your desire shall be to your husband. That's what the black woman don't want to accept. She don't, hey, and you're not teaching your daughters either. Give me Ezekiel 16 and 44. Y'all getting cut today. We bringing out all the scriptures, because I guarantee she learned to be loud like that from her mama. Her father should have spit in her face, is what the Bible said. She should have learned humility from her father. But since she didn't learn that from her father, because you're probably not married, you was probably raising your children, like most of our women, okay, most of our women are baby mamas.
Right.
Most of our women don't have a strong man that's leading and guiding
that's
the house.
Right.
If that's not true, that's okay. Huh?
I bet you're not married either.
Oh yeah, I am married.
That's right.
Yeah, I'm married. I'm married and I got children.
Right.
And all these brothers can bear witness to my relationship.
That's right.
With my
that's
wife.
Right. That's
right. Yeah, yeah. Get that on camera, that foolishness right there. Get that on camera. Bring that out, go ahead.
Ezekiel chapter 16, verse 44.
Bring it out. This is what the scriptures say about that right there. That little girl hollering and yelling at a man.
Behold.
Can you find me the spirit of it?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Bring that out.
Everyone that uses proverbs shall use this proverb against thee.
This proverb is used against the black community.
Saying, as is the mother,
as is the woman,
so is her daughter.
So is the little girl. Give me Numbers chapter 12, verse 14. This is what's supposed to happen to these little girls. Read that again.
Behold, everyone that uses proverbs shall use this proverb against thee.
What did it say?
Saying, as is the mother,
as is the mother,
so is her daughter.
So is her daughter.
That's right.
The mother ain't got no respect for the black man, and the little girl ain't got no respect for the black man either.
Read. This is the book of Numbers, chapter 12, verse 14.
This is what should have happened to the little girl following the mama with the tight pants
on
with no shame. Read.
And the Lord said unto Moses.
What did the Lord say?
If her father had but spit in her face.
If Miriam's father had spit in her face to humble her. Read.
She should be ashamed.
She would have been ashamed to speak against Moses.
Right.
She would have been ashamed to speak against a man
That's right.
Who God calls a God of this earth. Give me Psalms 82 and 6. Hold what you had, whatever you had. Give me Psalms 82. This is the shame that's supposed to come along with the black woman. She's supposed to understand that the so-called black man is this. Read that.
Psalms chapter 82 and verse 6.
Bring it out.
I have said, ye are God.
That's what the Bible say about the black man. It says that the black man are gods. How can a woman speak against a god?
Bring it out.
How can you not be silent when you step forward to God?
Right. That's right.
The real god bodies are the Israelite men.
That's right.
It ain't no god body outside the Israelite men. So if you a Christian, stop all that foolishness. You learned that in slavery.
Right.
If you a Muslim, stop all that foolishness. You learned it in slavery.
Yeah, right.
That's right.
If you anything other than an Israelite, death is coming to you. It ain't nothing anything could do to stop it. This final destination.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission. Minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone, 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.